Good afternoon. Try one more time. Good afternoon. Thank you again. I'm going to talk about how Infosys is doing something after they change my mic.
Thank you.
So I'm going to talk about new services. In quarter one, our new offerings grew at more than 40% sequentially quarter on quarter. How wonderful would it be if new services became majority part of Infosys business? Well, that is one of our responsibilities here. I'm going to share three or four very simple to understand client stories that you will all identify with as consumers, as customers. I want you to watch for three things in these client stories. The first one is approach. We talk about being a next generation services company. Well, how did we approach those situations as a next generation services company versus a traditional company that you may be familiar with, a competitor or wannabe? The second thing I want you to look for is the agility. No project that I'll talk about lasted more than 6 weeks. 6 week projects. And how much money did they make? We'll discuss that. But only 6 week projects. So the agility part of it. The third thing I want you to watch for is the same Infosys consultant who goes in for a traditional project, when he or she goes in for a new services project, how powerful she becomes amplified with Infosys software. So the approach, the agility, and the amplification. These three things. Let's start with the first project. Safe Harbor. EMEA is a company that runs the world's best loyalty programs. So if you go to the UK, half of the households in the UK have a Nectar card. In fact, in India, they run the loyalty programs for Axis Bank. They run the loyalty programs for Taj Hotels. So the board of EMEA approached us and said, we want to take part in India's e-commerce revolution. How can we get a piece of this action? $20 billion being spent on e-commerce in India, Flipkart, Amazon, Snapdeal, all of you shop on these websites. How do we get a piece of that action? What kind of business plan should we make? So we got all of them to Bangalore, set up a three-day design thinking workshop, invited all the local startups, e-commerce companies, even consumers who shop. They wanted to get 25 to 30-year-old consumers who are upwardly mobile who shop. You know, we have plenty of those in our campus. So they all came in for the design thinking workshop. 3 days later, their business plan was ready. This is how we will penetrate India. We will create an aggregate loyalty site, Nectar.in, and we will have consumers come in here to shop across 30 million SKUs. They can shop for items that are available on Flipkart, on Amazon, on Snapdeal, but they'll get a better price here. They'll get a better, assortment here. And they will earn loyalty points here for future shopping needs. And the platform they chose, and I'm very proud about this, was Scala. Scala is an acquisition that Infosys did. In fact, Ritika and I had led this due diligence in April 2015. It is one of our most successful acquisitions. Somebody had asked a question about acquisitions. Scala gave a e-commerce experience that is extremely superior. Now, let me bring that to life. When you go to a shopping site and click, and let's say you want to buy men's shirts, dress shirts, you have categories like that, right? On this website, and you can access it right now, you can go to Nectar.in and search for whatever you're looking for. This is the fastest search engine in the world, the best search engine in the world. And if you look for a category like, I am looking for a particular type of dress shirt, the drop-down categories will adjust dynamically. It's a responsive website. It also adjusts to any form factor that you personally are looking at. It's a superior e-commerce experience enabled by Scala. EMEA launched this website and has been driving up many, many consumers in India in the last few months. But this is not all that Scala does. This is just one illustration. I'd like to play a video on Scala to bring to life other things that Scala does along with us. Please watch.
Scava is a modern digital platform that makes it easy to create great experiences across all devices and form factors. We power next-generation commerce experiences across leading brands around the globe. Because of our robust technology platform, we market every experience faster, increase conversions, and improve overall engagement for our clients. SCAVA makes it easy for marketing and IT teams to quickly develop complex commerce-enabled digital experiences, saving our clients time and money. With SCAVA Studio, it takes just a few clicks on an intuitive drag-and-drop interface to update a site or app. SCAVA Studio is fully customizable. Marketing teams can create a number of pages and sites, select any layout from the library, and customize the layouts page. SCAVA Studio comes with ready-to-use authoring widgets and templates to easily and quickly build full e-commerce websites and native apps for desktop, mobile, and in-store. Engineering teams have the ability to create their own widgets and templates and reuse them on any website or app. Marketers have the power to simply update content, save, schedule, and publish their changes in real time. From marketing landing pages to digital catalogs and in-store displays, SCAVA Studio empowers retailers to manage a full range of digital experiences to quickly deliver relevant shopping experiences to their customers. Because of our technology, SCAVA is recognized as an industry leader. As part of the Infosys family, SCAVA is expanding its reach globally and expanding into new verticals. SCAVA continues to thrill and exceed the demands of its customers.
I like the next example. This is a large retailer, let's just say a very large retailer, whose shared services operations had a part which looked like a room like this. There were 75 people in the room, and all that the 75 people did was take supplier calls. This retailer has 17,000 suppliers, each one calling saying, "You paid me short than what I invoiced you." And those 75 individuals in that room used to open up the invoicing system, open up the purchase order system, open up the shipping details, and just validate whether they had paid right. And then they would say on the phone, "Sir, you're right. I paid you short. Now let me print a credit memo and give it to you." Each transaction like that took more than 4 minutes. And this retailer called us in saying, "Can you do something?" Now, a traditional services firm would use traditional business process outsourcing. I can do this cheaper from India, from China. I can use an on-site offshore. That's the traditional way of doing it. Infosys walked in, powered by a platform, a software called Assist Edge. Assist Edge, in 6 weeks, transformed that room into 25 people, first of all. So there was 50 people less. And the same job was getting done. So the rest of the job was not offshored, it was eliminated. So if ever you thought about the first arbitrage being offshoring, well, this is the second arbitrage, a much bigger arbitrage, eliminating the work completely. Assist Edge configured all that repetitive work. It was not cognitive, or as Vishal said, not mental. It was repetitive. It was absolutely codable, and Assist Edge configured it in weeks. In 6 weeks, the client dropped costs by 60-70%. But that's not the point. It wasn't the cost part. The more important part was the average handling time for each case came down to 1 minute. The backlog of suppliers calling them dramatically went down. And the processing capacity of that shared services center went up. This is the power of Assist Edge. Let me share one more short story on Assist Edge. Vodafone in New Zealand. How many of you would like to hear a down under accent from New Zealand? Can you understand the New Zealand accent? Yes, no?
Yes.
You should try it. I'll shortly play a video on it. Vodafone New Zealand has 2 million subscribers doing the broadband, mobile, fixed line, etc. But Vodafone New Zealand was brought up through acquisition. So they have 3 customer billing systems, which means when you call saying, I'm moving my home, just change my landline, it will take them an average of 37 minutes. They have to navigate through one system, find your account, navigate through the other system, find your billing details, the services you use, and so on. What is the right solution? A traditional services firm will say, you need a unified CRM. And sir, it will take you a 5-year transformation roadmap to drive that unified CRM. What did Infosys do? Please watch. Please play the video.
Vodafone New Zealand's goal is to be the most respected communications company in New Zealand.
We were largely a mobile company with some fixed customers. We purchased a very large fixed company. We realised very, very quickly that our customers didn't care about the fact that we had multiple CRM systems and multiple billing systems and different processes, and they just knew that they were a customer of Vodafone. When we found the Assist Edge product and we looked at the challenges that we had on multiple systems, we sort of had a eureka moment.
Well, what we did with the Assist Edge product, it allowed us to actually do things completely different and actually start redesigning processes in a way that linked into those legacy systems but made it really easy for us to change process fast and deliver better outcomes.
Assist Edge, in just under a year, it has united 3 disparate IT stacks into one, which has meant that now a single customer care representative can answer queries on a range of products in a consistent and meaningful way. They can speed out the rollout of new services to customers. So all in all, it's increased our velocity for customer care.
Right from the very start, when we were looking to select the partner we were going to go with, the Edgeviv team came in and we challenged them. We gave them 6 weeks. We need you to stand up a integrated view of one of our customers where it's point information from our 2 fixed CRMs, our mobile CRM, and to play that as a demonstration to our exec. And within 6 weeks, we achieved that. And that was fantastic because it proved that we were able to do things fast. It also showed that the Edgeviv suite with Assist Edge was going to deliver what we needed. And that was a great platform. It really made you feel good right from the very start that we were going to get some significant things out of this. Assist Edge plays in between our legacy systems and gives us that flexibility to really make rapid change. We're doing things for our customers and for our people. It's making them happy, it's our customers making our people happy. And as a result, we're getting great outcomes out of those processes. And that really lands delivering a better experience.
My next and last story is on Mana, something very exciting for us. This is an American large industrial conglomerate. They manufacture batteries, HVAC systems, electronics, and so on. They have 170,000 employees, so there's a large company, over 1,300 locations. What is the traditional thing most companies do? Most services companies do in this kind of place. Find out the IT shop and figure out how much can be offshored. Well, that's all gone. This company has completely optimized their IT spend. They have offshored very well. They use great productivity tools and so on. But they still have a problem. They have a cost savings challenge. They also have a lot of issues coming out of IT, critical, business critical stability issues coming out of IT. So this company asked us for a platform on their automation journey. So this is a pure platform sale. Mana was sold as an enterprise license here. The first thing we did with Mana was quickly get the quick wins out. The small L1, L2 tickets that Ravi talked about earlier, job monitoring, server monitoring, alert monitoring, very repetitive tasks, etc. That was a quick win. That was within days. We ingested all possible sources of data from the enterprise, about 2 million records of data from 100 plus sources, tickets, source codes, keystrokes, infrastructure logs, error logs, etc. And then we started looking at more sophisticated L3 work, where now this is cognitive or mental work. You start thinking about diagnosing what is the problem, which applications are causing the problem, which processes are causing the problem, and started finding causes to that. That showed that of all the 350,000 incidents that were created, incidents means breakdowns. Of all the 350,000 breakdowns that are created, more than 250,000 could either be predicted, automated, eliminated. That means a huge deal for the smooth functioning of the company. Forget about cost. This is about smooth, streamlined operations. We didn't stop there. We used some natural language programming, and Sudhir can explain more about what that is, to mine the comments made in the tickets that were created, and then start thinking about patterns as to what events happen even before a ticket is raised, even before a breakdown happens. So you can start predicting breakdowns before they happen. That's a very interesting story. If you can start predicting what happens, well, you can guess what the Infosys stock will be tomorrow. That was a joke. The next thing we did was apply MANA to their core enterprise licenses. Sorry, tomorrow markets are closed. That's right. That's why it was a joke. My CFO pointed out that tomorrow the markets are closed. Then we started putting MANA onto how they work on their licenses. So on the messaging platform, on the integration platform, we found that they were paying for a messaging license that was pay-per-use, but they were not using most of the license. That's $2 million of savings right there. Now we are putting MANA on end-to-end on their SAP systems, ERP systems, to track business processes and predict business processes end-to-end. Overall, in a few weeks, actually 6 weeks again, ironically, we have uncovered a business case for saving more than $21 million for this enterprise. And that with 6 weeks of MANA. Let me review some credentials for MANA. You can ignore the gobbledygook up here. It is just meant to intimidate you. This is Syngenta, one of the clients who were the first adopters of MANA. They've used it across the enterprise now with great success. Johnson Controls, another company that has adopted MANA very well. To summarize, the new Infosys approaches every engagement with this software amplified approach, with agile projects, with delivering results every 6 weeks or less, and with every Infosys consultant practically becoming an Iron Man armed with software. Thank you very much. I will now invite Mohit Joshi to the stage.
Thank you.